video is going to address one of the most asked questions that I have gotten ever since starting my YouTube channel. Well, okay, actually, that's not quite true. This is the most asked question I've gotten ever since anyone was actually watching my YouTube channel. Because the truth is that I made videos for a while and they didn't get very many views until I finally figured out how to actually make good videos and how the YouTube algorithm actually works. So in this video, I'm gonna be teaching you the method that I use for scripting my YouTube videos so that they come off sounding pretty polished and professional. But here's what I really want you to understand. If you watched me film my videos, you would have a different opinion on how good of a speaker Gillian is. I get comments all the time that say, wow, you're so polished, you're so professional, you never pause, you never mess up, you never say, how do you do it? How do you script your videos? And really, the real secret is editing. I mean, I'm not filming this flawlessly. I say some things, I mess up, I say them again and again and again and again until I get them right. Then we edit all that out. I'll talk more about the exact... Later on in this video, I'll go into greater detail about the exact filming and editing process that we use to produce these videos so that they end up looking and sounding like they do. But first of all, let's just talk about the scripting aspect. So as far as scripting goes, I've pretty much tried it all. Everything from scripting every single word that I say, basically reading off a teleprompter, all the way to completely winging it with no notes at all. And honestly, neither of those extremes worked for me very well. Scripting every word sounds like it would make you come off as polished and professional, but really? It makes you come off as unnatural and awkward, and everyone can tell that you're reading off a teleprompter. It's also just really hard to film videos in that way because you're trying to look at the camera, but you have these notes and you're trying to stick exactly to them. Maybe the teleprompter's right next to the camera, so you're trying to figure out where exactly to look, or maybe you just have the notes on your phone or your computer, so you're looking back and forth and back and forth over and over again and constantly not saying exactly what the notes say and having to say it again. So yeah, it's difficult. It also is just very time consuming because that means you had to write all the words for the video and then you had to film the entire video. So you're essentially writing a blog post and video when you only needed to film a video. So those are some of the problems with overscripting. Now let's talk about why underscripting doesn't work. I mean, you probably know this, maybe from experience. If you don't have any notes for your video, you're gonna wind up feeling really disorganized. Your videos will be rambly. They're going to be hard to edit because you don't even know what you were trying to say. Your videos will lack focus. And something that you might not expect exactly is that you'll feel like you have nothing to say. Now, I don't think that this happens to everyone, but I definitely have experienced this. If I don't have at least a bit of an outline that I'm working with, then I start talking. I can talk about one thing for a little while, but then I don't remember what else I was gonna say in the video. And I just feel like I have nothing to say. So neither of those extremes worked for me. But here's what does. Using a bullet point outline. Typically, when I'm filming a video, I have anywhere between 3 and 10 bullet points that I'm working off of. This gives me a basic outline, and it means that I can remember to include everything in the video that I wanted to include. Working from a bullet point outline allows me to keep the video very organized, and it also means that I can remember to add in plenty of valuable information. But because I haven't scripted every single word, I'm still able to speak naturally to the camera. I don't sound like a robot and I don't look like I'm reading from a teleprompter because I'm not. Now, I think that sometimes just because I am a bit of a perfectionist and I say things over and over again until I get them exactly right and then we edit all that out, that sometimes it can end up almost seeming like I am reading from a teleprompter. And I say that because I've had a lot of people ask me, Are you reading from a teleprompter? But that's really my personal problem with perfectionism, I think, coming through, because when you see me talking to the camera, I'm not reading notes. This is just me saying what I think I should say based on that outline that I created. So let me share with you about exactly how I create this bullet point outline to guide me through the process of filming my videos. Step number one is pretty obvious. It's just to decide exactly what the video is about. So what is the topic of the video? You may have already done this. If so, great. Moving on to the next step. Step two is to decide the outcome for the video. What is the purpose of this video? Am I trying to entertain? Am I trying to inspire? Or am I trying to educate? And most often in my videos, I'm trying to educate. But I have to take it a step further than that. I don't want to just say, okay, this is an educational video. I have to say, okay, by the end of this video, what do I want to have taught the viewer? What change do I want to have made in the viewer's life? What do I want to help them understand? Really, my intention for every video that I make is to somehow change your life for the better. And of course, I don't always accomplish that. Not every video is groundbreaking. Not every video is applicable to you in your life, but that's my intention for every video, that every video creates a transformation in somebody's life. So that's step two. Now let's move on and talk about step three. Step three is where I get all my ideas out on paper. I create a messy brainstorm. I'm not going for structure or organization here. I'm just trying to get my ideas out of my head and on paper so I don't forget any of them and they can all get included in the video. Then in step four, I take that messy outline and I organize it. This is where I'm actually planning out the video. And sometimes when I'm in this part of the process, I can wind up scripting some parts of it. I write full sentences. Basically, I'm trying to plan what I'm going to say. But I still don't worry too much about things like grammar or complete sentences. I'm just going for ideas here and I'm trying to get them into an organized flow so that the video will make sense. The final step of this process is when I take that outline and I turn it into simplified bullet points. Instead of having that script that I'm trying to read, I want to transform that script into a series of very short bullet points. Most often, I'm working from single word bullet points. So I'll just have somewhere between 3 and 10 bullet points that are each one word or one short phrase. And this really guarantees that I won't wind up reading my notes in the video and that I'll have to use my brain while I'm making the video. And that might sound a little bit funny, but let me just explain what I mean. When I was scripting my videos in more detail, I was writing more of every word that I was going to say, I found that I could only say those things because I was using so much of my brain just to read the words and remember them long enough that I could say them to the camera. But now that I script my videos so much more sparingly, I have to use my brain to think about what I'm going to say as I'm talking, just like we normally do when we're talking. It means that my videos feel a lot more natural and conversational, and honestly, they're more enjoyable for me to create because I feel like I'm connecting with you guys a lot better. Now I want to tell you guys a little bit about what the whole process looks like from filming to editing to finished product. But before I do that, I just wanted to mention that this process that I just talked about for creating my notes for the video, it also works really well for public speaking. So if you ever are going to give a presentation and you're trying to not just have your face in your notes and be reading a script that you wrote, but you also are worried about, you know, not knowing what to say, you can use the method that I just talked you through in order to deliver a great presentation. First choosing the topic of your presentation, then deciding what the objective for your presentation is, then writing a big, messy brainstorm of everything you want to include, organizing that into something of a script, and then refining that script down to just a few bullet points. Once you go through that entire process, you'll find that all of your ideas really become concrete in your mind and you'll have them mentally tied to each of those bullet points. So when you see the next bullet point that you're supposed to talk about, you'll remember all of these stories and anecdotes and facts and numbers that you wanted to mention in relation to that bullet point. And of course, it goes without saying that if you're giving a presentation, you'll also need to practice the presentation. When I'm filming my YouTube videos, I don't really practice filming them because we have the power of editing. However, if you're giving a presentation, you're not gonna be able to edit stuff out, so you need to practice it so you make sure that you can nail it. Okay, let's move on. Let's talk about the process from filming all the way to editing. So, first of all, I create my notes for the video, just like we just talked about, those five steps, and I end up with this bullet point plan for what I'm gonna say in the video. Then I set everything up. You know, I turn the lights on, set the camera up, do my makeup, all that, sit down, and I talk to the camera. Now, I just leave the camera running the entire time I'm filming the video. And for context, typically if I'm filming a video that ends up being about 10 minutes long, the footage is probably 15 to 20 minutes long. So it's gonna be 50 to 100% longer than the length that the video ends up. And that's because if I mess up, then I stop and I say the same thing again. And that way we can just cut out the part that had a mistake. Here's what I don't do. I don't stop the camera if I mess up. I don't stop talking and start talking all over from the beginning of the video. It's just not necessary, and it would make the filming process take a lot longer. So using this method, I film the entire video. If I mess up, I just stop and pause, back up to the beginning of that sentence or so, and then keep going. I work my way all the way through my notes, wrap up the video, and that's that. Then I take that footage and either I edit it or I send it off to my editor. These days I normally send it off to my editor because I have other things I need to do with my time, and he can do it just fine. He can listen to the video and cut out all the mistakes, because that's really all it is. Yes, there are lots of things you can do in addition when you're editing your videos, but 90% of good editing is just cutting out the mistakes if we're talking about a talking head video like this. If we were making a film, then good editing would mean something completely different, but for a video like this, we mostly just need to cut out the mistakes. The other things that might happen during editing are color correction. If I'm too bright or too dark or too yellow or too pink or anything like that, you know, we might want to fix the color. The other thing is just like adding in any graphics. This should be done sparingly. We typically just add in the title graphic, the end screen, and then maybe a few topic cards or words on the screen. So it's gonna be mostly text-based graphics, not lots of fancy things flying all over the place, just because that can end up looking really tacky really fast. We also don't have a bunch of weird transitions, so you're not gonna see like one screen flipping around to the next most of the time. Simple cuts are the easiest and really produce the most professional look. So I think that that is pretty much everything you need to know about how I script my videos. The process is pretty simple. Long story short, it's bullet points. Bullet points will allow you to speak naturally to the camera while at the same time not forgetting anything, which means your videos will end up being valuable and interesting and you won't run out of things to say. Now, before you go, one more thing. Now you know how to make awesome videos, so you need to know how to get people to actually watch them, because YouTube is a really competitive place. Am I right? And I don't want you to waste your time making videos that nobody watches, especially if you're making really good, valuable, interesting videos. I want people to see them. So I want to teach you exactly how the YouTube algorithm works so that you can get your videos to rank really well and get plenty of views. I'm doing a free workshop that's coming up here pretty soon called How to Get Views on YouTube with Zero Subscribers. So if you're just starting out, your channel's really small, maybe you have zero subscribers, or maybe you just have a few hundred or a couple thousand subscribers, and you're trying to get people to actually watch your videos, then check the description box down below for a link to sign up for the workshop. Like I said, the workshop is free, and I know that it can have a big impact on your YouTube channel, and honestly, on your whole life. I know my YouTube channel has had a major impact on my life. Every area of my life. So check the link down below, sign up for the workshop, and I can't wait to see you there. Okay, well that's everything for today's video, guys. If you're new here and you haven't yet subscribed, make sure you do that right now. Click that red button down below. That will ensure that you do not miss my next video. Actually, clicking that subscribe button won't ensure that. Clicking the subscribe button will help you possibly find out about my next video. If you wanna make sure you find out about it, then hit that bell too. When you hit the bell, you will get a notification when my next video comes out. And I make 2 videos every single week that you definitely don't want to miss. So do it. Click the bell right now so you don't miss my next video. Okay, thanks so much for watching, guys. I hope you're having a fantastic week, and I'll see you again really soon. Okay, this is weird. It's like I'm sitting on my own shoulder. It's not gonna work. Or I could back all the way up and begin again talking. Okay, let's scrap this. I'm going way too long about this. Make the video very rich, very full, very valuable. Make the video very rich. Make the video very full of valuable information and really rich. Make the video, make the video rich. This is something, what am I trying to say? If you watched me film my videos, you probably would have a different perspective, a different opinion on how good of a speaker I am. I'll say that a different way.